It's possibly the most watched speech a president will ever give. Of course, I'm talking about the State of the Union. President Obama gives his on Tuesday. He'll lay out his agenda for the year, but it's a very different political landscape from what it was a year ago. Joining me now from Washington to talk about the stakes for this speech is Craig Crawford, columnist with CQPolitics.com. Craig, good to see you.
Good morning, Randi.
Good morning to you. First of all, what's different about this landscape? Sort of set the picture for us and why this is such an important speech at this time.
Well, usually these speeches are not remembered for substance, more for ritualized pomp and circumstances. You know, it's been said Washington is Hollywood for ugly people, and this is our Academy Award, so it gets a lot of attention, and it's hard for presidents to be remembered for them very much. I think there's one difference here. Coming so soon after the Tucson tragedy, I think there's a chance we'll see a little more civility, a little more unity. There's even talk of Democrats and Republicans sitting together instead of apart. And the president, I think if he gave a speech like he did in Tucson, this one could be more remembered.
And what do you think, what can we expect to hear from the president? I mean, what do you think the tone of the speech will be?
Unity, civility, and most of all, jobs. I think the president will talk a lot about jobs. We'll probably hear that word quite a few times. I don't know if he'll make any proposals, but that is something that I think he is paramount for him to focus the country on, how he is working on getting more jobs. The civility, I think, comes after the Tucson tragedy, gives him an opportunity to really get above the politics and put a lot of pressure on Republicans to be more bipartisan. And I think he'll reach out to them. He may even throw them some bones, like talking about cutting spending and so on, to show the country that he wants to get along, so that if they don't get along in the future, they know it's not his fault.
Right. Make them look like the bad guys. You really believe that the two parties are actually going to sit together?
I've already heard that one delegation, the Colorado delegation, is going to do that, and there's some talk about others doing it. That would be a big change, because usually these things turn out very partisan, and you see the applause, the president's party stands up and cheers, and the other side sits down, and the country never likes that. That never looks good. You know, people want more bipartisanship in Washington, and this would be a good way for the politicians to show that.
And, you know, we've seen before some members of Congress have acted out a bit during
yeah.
these speeches. Do you expect everybody to be on their best behavior?
I think that's another change coming so soon after Tucson. I think that would be very dangerous for that to happen. You had one congressman stand up and yell at the president, "You lie," in the last one. I would be very surprised to see that again.
And after Tucson, the president really did get a boost. I mean, not after that memorial mm-hmm. Ceremony, and even his poll numbers are up slightly. How critical is this speech to sort of carry that forward?
I think it would be great for him if he took a page from his own notebook. That speech in Tucson was simple, it was direct, it was personal. That's the key. I think Obama learned something in that speech that he ought to carry forward into the State of the Union. Usually these State of the Union addresses are laundry lists of lots of agenda items to generate lots of applause. Speechwriters write a lot of applause lines in these because the media tends to count the number of times they get applause and compare that to past presidents. And the speeches are usually fairly undisciplined. But I think that Tucson speech was a real model for him, particularly that personal tone and talking mm-hmm. about individual people and getting back to the job scene. He should talk about people who have lost their jobs and personalize that more. Those are the kind of things he did in Tucson that he should do again.
All right. Craig Crawford, columnist with CQPolitics.com. We will be watching that speech along with you. Thank you so much.
Good to be here.
And remember, you can see the president's State of the Union address live right here on CNN, 9 p.m. Eastern Tuesday. And be sure to stick around for complete analysis after the speech from the best political team on television.